Hey, look at this ice cube.
Wait, what?
This ice is actually methane hydrate, a combination of water and methane. It's the methane that burns as the water melts away. And depending on who you ask, this is a huge potential source of natural gas, a serious risk to our climate, or, you know, both. Now, usually methane just bubbles through water. It doesn't really dissolve much. But under the enormous pressure and in the cold temperatures of the ocean, something weird happens. This forms. Here's a methane hydrate on the molecular level. Okay, so these red dots, these are all oxygen atoms in water molecules. We hid the hydrogens because otherwise it gets to be too crazy. Now, this may look like a disordered mess, but eventually, as your eyes adjust, you'll see these cage-like arrangements of water molecules. And of course, like any cage, there's a space in the middle. And those spaces are where methane molecules can get trapped. Now, two things can keep this cage stable. High enough pressure from other molecules pushing in on the cage, or temperatures low enough that the molecules don't escape due to their normal vibrations and gyrations. And if the pressure is high enough, methane hydrates can even be stable at room temperature. Most of the methane in these hydrates comes from deep sea bacteria, which give it off as waste, and the ocean supplies the water. And most methane hydrate is buried in sediment around the edges of the continents. Now, there is a lot of ocean, there's a lot of bacteria in the ocean, so there are gigatons of methane hydrates. And one cubic meter of the stuff, when it melts, can release up to 180 cubic meters of methane gas. So if all this melted tomorrow, we'd end up with this much methane. Now this is kind of a big range, but it's at least 3,800 times the amount of methane the US burned in all of 2016. If it's really cold, like in the Arctic, methane hydrates can actually form outside of the ocean, in or under the Arctic permafrost. In fact, some of the undersea methane hydrate deposits around the Arctic Ocean formed on land and then got covered with ocean when sea levels rose at the end of the last ice age. Now, all of this methane sitting around is pretty tempting given our voracious appetite for fossil fuels, and some countries, especially Japan, are exploring ways to extract the methane and burn it for energy. But of course, there are some risks. Burning methane releases less CO2 than other fossil fuels, so it's seen as cleaner, but look, you're still burning a fossil fuel here. And a while back, some researchers were concerned that warming temperatures could destabilize methane hydrates and release methane into the atmosphere very, very quickly. And that would be, you know, not good because methane is actually a far more potent greenhouse gas than carbon dioxide. But for more on that, check out this video. Scientists now think, though, that all except the shallowest methane hydrates seem pretty stable, and most of the methane released from the seafloor would probably be eaten by oceanic bacteria before it ever got to the surface. So an extreme doomsday scenario where a bunch of undersea methane is unleashed, that doesn't really seem very likely. The most vulnerable hydrates would actually be the ones that are on land, locked up in the Arctic permafrost that could one day thaw. Fossil fuel friend or climate change foe, burning ice, still pretty freaking cool. Huge thanks to the US Geological Survey for helping us out with this video and letting us use their methane hydrate footage. By the way, it's Earth Week, and we are celebrating. Check out acs.org/ccew for more. And to make sure you get more videos like this one, please click right here and then click that subscribe button and then scroll down a bit and click that alarm bell. I know it's a lot of steps, but it really helps us out. Thanks, and we'll see you next week.